Two USB-52 bombers have flown over the disputed South China Sea, in a move that could inflame tensions ahead of a key regional defense summit in Singapore where the US and Chinese defense ministers are slated to meet. The two US Air Force bombers departed from the Anderson Air Force Base in Guam as part of a routine training mission in the vicinity of the South China Sea, the Pacific Air Forces said in a statement on Thursday. Tuesday's operation was part of the U.S. Indo-Pacific Command's continuous bomber presence operations since March 2004, and was consistent with international law and a long-standing commitment to a free and open Indo-Pacific, it said. The mission, which is likely to draw Beijing's ire, was carried out while U.S. Defense Secretary James Mattis was visiting Vietnam before heading to Singapore on Thursday. There he will attend the annual Association of Southeast Asian Nations, ASEAN, Defense Ministers meeting, where he is expected to meet his Chinese counterpart Wei Fenghe. Mattis cancelled a proposed meeting with Wei in Beijing after a near collision between a U.S. and a Chinese warship last month. The U.S. later said the meeting was called off after Mattis was told that Wei was not available to meet him. But Randall Shriver, the U.S. Assistant Secretary of Defense for Asian and Pacific Security Affairs, told reporters this week that Beijing had requested the Singapore meeting, signaling a potential upturn in military relations. He said there were frictions after Washington slapped sanctions on a key unit of the Chinese military in September for buying Russian fighter jets and missiles, but that may be a relatively short bump in the road. The fact that he's meeting with Minister Wei is some evidence that the Chinese are interested in keeping things normal and stable, as are we, he said. Our impression is that the Chinese military wants to keep things stable. But the latest U.S. operations in the South China Sea this week may anger Beijing. The Chinese government has frequently protested about American bombers' routine training missions in the skies above the disputed waters, where Beijing has multiple overlapping claims with its regional neighbors. Following the most recent B-52 mission in the area in September, China's defense ministry spokesman Ren Qiaqian called the action provocative, and said Beijing would take all necessary means to safeguard our rights and interests. Earlier this week, Mattis criticized China's predatory behavior towards smaller countries, although he stressed the U.S. was not out to contain China. Bilateral ties have been rocked in recent months by a series of events, including the near collision between the two ships in the South China Sea at the end of September. In the South China Sea, over many American administrations, we have said that in international airspace, international waters, we will fly or sail. You've seen that continue, Mattis said on Monday. We remain highly concerned with continued militarization of features in the South China Sea.